the recognized worldwide leader in sports.
Wrestling Challenge comes to you this week from the Rochester War Memorial in Rochester, New York, where during the month of November, the folks here in upstate New York can look forward to some great events featuring the Rochester Americans, the AHL hockey action, as well as some fine family entertainment from the Ice Capades. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wrestling Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, along with Bobby the Brain Heenan,
the host.
We've got action galore lined up for you here this week, so bat down the hatches, find your favorite chair. We're coming at you right now. We talked about action galore this week here on Wrestling Challenge, and we've got it. We're going to be taking a look at the big guy, the latest big guy in the Bam Bam Bigelow, the guy you said you had, Brain.
I don't want to talk about that.
I guess you don't. And take a look at this, the Ultimate Warrior, the man who can give Ravishing Rick a run for the money.
Be serious.
I am serious. Tag team action galore. Here's the British Bulldogs, along with Matilda, take on the new Dream Team, the form of Dino Bravo, of course, and the Hammer, Greg Valentine, and Luscious John will be there as well.
Will the you dog be better. There?
He certainly will. The reigning Intercontinental Champion, the Macho, the Honky Tonk Man. I'm so used to saying the Macho Man because, in my book, he was one of the greatest.
Get used
champions.
To saying Honky Tonk, well, the greatest Intercontinental Champion of them all.
That's yet to be decided. Also, Strike Force joining us, special tag team title match on the line against the Hearts. It's all up for grabs.
This is a one-ball contest. Introducing first, making his way to the ring along with his manager, Oliver Humperdinck, from Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing 394 pounds, Bam Bam Bigelow. And his opponent, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 230 pounds, Terry Gibbs.
Terry Gibbs against Bam Bam Bigelow. Gotta admit, Brain, that for a guy that's right on top of that 400-pound mark, this guy is the most agile guy you've ever seen.
He's extremely agile, but that size, doing all that aerial stuff he does, he's eventually going to tear out his knees, his back. He's going to hurt something. The guy's just a loudmouth show-off.
The guy is spectacular, admit it.
I don't like a guy that draws on himself.
Yeah. Well, you just like... wish that guys like King Kong Bundy could move around like that.
Are you kidding?
Look at this agility. Cartwheel right over the top of Gibbs. And a leapfrog as well. Oh, right between the eyes. Standing drop kick. Can Bundy do that? No.
Bundy can
Gang do that? No. Can Andre do that? No.
Aren't you going to let me answer?
Yes, go ahead.
They can all do that.
Oh, yeah.
That's where he probably copied this stuff from.
Well, we're waiting to see that, in fact. However, we may wait a long time. Well, Bam Bam Bigelow, as we said, a hot item here in the World Wrestling Federation. Consequently, a big spread in the latest World Wrestling Federation magazine. If you're not aware, Brain, it's on page 42. But this guy has created a lot of enemies. Would you not agree?
No. I'm amazed.
You're shocked. You can't even talk. Look at that slingshot from the outside. Goodbye, Gibbs. Just like that, it's all over. It's history. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, Bam Bam Bigelow.
How can people possibly like this guy? The way he's dressed, full of tattoos, and he's managed by a guy that looks like he belongs in a deck
like
of cards.
They love him. Here comes the big splash right over there. Really put the lights out for him. Right now, let's go to a special report on the special demolition incident.
You know, Ken Patera and Billy Jack Haynes share a lot of things in common. They're both from Portland. They both use their strength and talent to achieve success in the World Wrestling Federation. And both believe in the American way, that hard work will pay off, no shortcuts. And now they are together. This stemming from an incident occurring last week when Mr. Fuji's demolition, well after the bell, continued to ring the bell of Billy Jack Haynes' cousin, Brady Boone.
Now
this is ridiculous. They won the match. Look at this. They're going for a third one.
Showing pure Fuji-like behavior. Axe and smashes, blatant uncalled for abuse on Boone, brought out cousin Billy Jack.
Well, you know what I like? The kissing cousins are eating canvas now.
Oh, no.
Don't tell me this is going to happen to Billy Jack. Demolition drops the elbow. Oh, he's coming in.
Oh, here's Ted Patera.
Demolition was indeed true to their name, but Billy Jack Haynes and Ken Patera most definitely would have fared better had it been a fair match, that is, one-on-one or two-on-two. Naturally, Axe and Smash have a different thought on that.
Billy Jack Haynes and Patera, you were the one that started the problem, and what happened? We broke you right in half.
Smash, are these two guys dumb or what? They couldn't beat us when they snuck up, and now we're face to face.
Demolition, you've created a problem that you're not going to be able to solve, but we're going to solve it once and for all when we get you in the ring one more time.
Demolition, blood is thicker than water. You're big, you're bad, you're tough, but family will prevail in the...
And by the way, the contract has been offered, and with both sides eager to meet, no doubt about that, look for Haynes and Patera to take on Axe and Smash.
He's like two Rick Rude.
No, he's kind of a poor man's Rick Rude. You know what I mean by that?
No, not exactly.
Well, Rick Rude not only has a natural body, but he's worked at it. This guy's had to work at it all his life. So obviously, he's never had a job or an education, because you can't build a body like that and have a job and go to school. So what the guy's done is he probably can't spell or read or write, but he looks fairly good.
In other words, you're extremely envious and jealous.
I am not.
Oh, it's quite obvious you are.
Like I said, he's a poor man's Rick Rude.
Look at, he is thick everywhere. He not only has that heavy bulk, he's got definition as
well. Shut up, rednecks!
I'm talking to you, Monsoon.
Horowitz calling me a redneck? I can't believe that. He better concentrate on the gentleman he's facing right inside that squared circle. As Brain, I'm surprised that...
Oh, what a chop!
Huh? This guy is dynamic. In fact, we had a chance to ask him for a few choice words, and you don't have to wind this guy up too many times.
Oh, no, brother, it's not an earthquake, and it's not a semi-truck coming through the hell out of your house. It's the Ultimate Warrior, and I'm bringing it, just like the thunder and lightning from the skies above. The Ultimate Warrior is bringing the power of the warriors to the... Come and get it, brother! Oh!
Does he lack confidence? Highly unlikely.
There's something wrong with this guy.
Oh, look at this press slam.
He's dangerous. He's a very dangerous man.
That's 240 pounds. He's got extended fully up there midair.
What's he going to do, pitch him out in the audience?
He may. Oh, he just turned around and turned him loose. He is something else. Down for the cover. Goodbye.
That man's schizophrenic. There's something wrong with him.
What an impressive showing here by the Ultimate Warrior.
At the Richfield Coliseum on Thanksgiving, November the 26th, 50 World Wrestling Federation superstars and all assembled under one roof in the ladies' competition, 2 5-member teams. 10 tag teams in all in that exciting tag team elimination matchup. There will be 4 5-man teams in 2 10-man elimination matchups. In that first big one, Hulk Hogan, to captain a team of five, going against Andre the Giant and his fivesome, Macho Man Randy Savage. Over the past weeks, I have looked in your eyes, and I can see hatred, bitter hatred. And I know that it stems from that incident on Saturday night's main event between you and the man that's going to be captaining the opposing fivesome, the Honky Tonk Man. And you certainly have got your troops ready for this one.
Yeah, the Survivor Series has caught the imagination of people all around the world. Yeah, but focusing in on one guy, bang, bang. Yeah, I got you shot, and I got you down real, real down. Yeah, the imagination that I have right now is how many ways and how many, I got my team ready, me and Gene Okerlund, and you're right. Nightmares from Elizabeth affect the Macho Man Randy Savage, and Saturday night's main event will never be forgotten.
I know that is
never be forgotten.
Very sensitive subject, but how is Elizabeth getting along these days?
Physical pain, yeah. The sore shoulder and the sore jaw is all healed now, but the emotional scars are still there. And in the Survivor Series, what an opportunity to make her feel all right. Yeah, put the spark back in her eye, and all I gotta do, yeah, is get my team real, real, real psyched up. And I'm talking all the way to the top of the roof of the Richfield Coliseum, and then let it happen, yeah. Let it happen. Let the honky-tonk man suffer, yeah. Elizabeth will be there, me, Gene Okerlund. She'll be there real, real, real pretty. And it's going to be rehabilitation when she sees the survivors. Our team, yeah.
Well, folks, last week we promised you a special, very interesting match between the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and one George the Animal Steel. However, it seems that George the Animal Steel is nowhere to be found.
I know where he is. It's feeding time at the zoo. He's
Let's go to the Million Dollar Man, please.
That idiot, the animal, he couldn't even find the building. He got lost. So you know what that means? It means another victory for the Million Dollar Man. Of course, I like to win by competing. But yet, a victory is a victory. And a victory means more of this. And I like all of that I can get.
Well, DiBiase, in fact, gets a victory in the record book and gets the money as well to put more in his pocket. But we've got an outstanding match headed your way right now. Oh, there she goes. Went right after Dino Bravo.
These people are cheering a dog biting a human. Can you imagine that?
The hammer got out of there in a hurry.
Shows you what our society's getting to.
Actually, I have to give credit where credit is due, Brain. I have to say you're absolutely right. This will be a main event in any arena in the entire world.
Of course I'm right. I'm Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Oh, excuse me. Sorry, I mentioned it. Got rid of. Nice shoulder block by Dino. Sends Davey Boy down. Quickly dropped down in front. Look out. Leapfrog. Beautiful. High hip lock. Nailed him with it. Deep arm drag. Dino wants out. I don't blame him. He didn't do anything right.
It's early. Stick around.
Excuse me. Tag made also on the other side, and Dynamite's in there now. Another nice shoulder block. He's back to 100%. Watch it. Look at it. Snap suplex. Nailed him with it.
And what does Greg go, about 270?
Absolutely.
I'll tell you one thing about this team of the Bulldogs. They do quick tags. That's what you have to do.
You want to survive in tag team action, you better know how to operate inside that square circle. Nice single leg trip by the hammer.
Speaking of surviving in survival series, that 10-man tag match is going to be something.
Well, it certainly is. And the interesting point of view from my side of the story is that even when you're eliminated, your partner's got to go as well. He's got to get out.
That's right. But if you want to put some money on it and make a little side bet, I'd put my money on the Islanders.
You would, huh?
Yes, I would.
Well, it's Turkey Day, and you may be the turkey.
I've never been a turkey.
Dino caught him coming in. Rammed the knee right into the kisser of Dynamite. And the tide has turned here in this one. Elbow. Nailed him with it. Could be all over. Nope.
How's Dino doing now, huh, Loudmouth?
Well, hey. The Dream Team was a great combination when it had Brutus the Barber Beefcake as one of their members.
But they dumped him, and now they're even better.
The hammer now going to work on the leg in the lower abdomen with that shot, but you can bet he's going to be trying to soften up those legs. Boy, he telegraphed that move.
A little too much. Old Davey Boy was standing there doing nothing.
Wasn't paying attention. Almost kicked Matilda off the apron.
Should have kicked her in the third row.
Oh, here he goes now. We talked about it earlier on. Oh, he went for it. Got caught, rammed right into the turnbuckle. Look at this windup. He won't get it. He'll be out of there.
He wound up once too many times.
He's looking to get out, make a hasty retreat. Makes the tag to Dino. And the tag is made to Davey. Both freshmen in. Davey Boy Smith, Irish whip. Big backdrop. Whoa. Excuse me, Valentine hadn't even got out of there yet. Davey Boy gave him a little assistance. Power slam, perhaps. Tag is made. There it is.
Davey Boy's illegal. Oh, he shouldn't be in there.
The tag. Are you blind?
But he shouldn't be in there.
Oh, look at that. Luscious came in and pulled the leg of Dynamite right off the shoulders of Davey Boy. Now they're all in there. The bell is rung. I would assume we've had a disqualification here. Oh, the hammer just got nailed. He's out of there. Both Dynamite and Davey going out now.
Oh, no, they're going to stick the dog on him.
I hope so. Oh, there she goes. Matilda driving him right back towards the locker room. Look at Dino running for his life. And here comes Matilda. She's going to do a number again.
Wait, Johnny V is trapped. They've got him trapped.
Luscious is caught right in the center of the ring. Oh, double headbutt. He's in no man's land right now. Suplex coming up. The bell is still ringing.
Can't anybody stop this?
They've got him
trapped. The manager.
What's this? Got him straddled up there.
Uh-oh. I could break the man's back door.
Oh, we're going to see a suplex. Yes. I believe it's one.
Two against one.
Two against one. That's not fair. Let's get the official word.
The winners of this bout resulting from a disqualification, the British Bulldogs.
Bulldogs getting the Duke here on a disqualification, but Luscious is really out of it. Oh, look at that. Matilda's protected.
That's disgraceful. That is downright disgraceful.
I love it.
He better get some medical help.
He certainly will need it. Right now, Matilda is protecting him. Right now, let's go to a special interview with the Hulkster and his survival team.
I've never seen anything quite like it. The troops are lining up for the Survivor Series in Richfield, Ohio, just outside of Cleveland. Don't think for a minute I don't recognize those 24-inch guns. Captain Hulk Hogan.
Well, you better believe it, Mean Gene. I wanted them to know in the Bobby Heenan camp that we were watching a man. That's why I climbed on the largest mountain in the world, brother. And when I was on top of the mountain, I let them know I was watching a man. They're like a bunch of caged animals, man. They're ready to survive. That's what I like. Once they knew I was watching, man, their weaknesses, their flaws, I saw them all, brother. They backed into a corner, man. They're ready to fight right now. And so are we, brother. The strongest man in the world. If I become tired, weary, and weak, I'm going to soak your powers, man. Steal from your body to guide me through. The prophet superstar Billy Graham, the man with the power, the master blaster, has told me what it takes to survive. As far as Bam Bam Bigelow, I'm counting on him to even up the odds, brother, when it gets real, real heavy.
What about him?
As far as you, man, as far as you go, the history between this man, I'm not asking for your word. All I want is you to make a stand.
You got to
survive with us.
Yes.
All right, let's talk about it, gentlemen. Captain Hulk Hogan, Paul Orndorff. What a night this is going to be.
You know,
bad elimination.
You know, I didn't get to the position that I am now without being a survivor. I've done what I've had to do. I've scratched, I've called, I've bit, I've used dirt, I've done everything. And I know where Bobby Heenan's coming from. I know where each and every one of the people are at. And that's why that we will come out of this ring a winner.
All right, Bam Bam Bigelow.
You know, you got five of the strongest men in the world in that ring, and we're going to survive.
Ken Patera.
You know, I ran with the pack just like Mr. Wonderful did at one time. And we know how devious and how cruel they can be. But I'm going to tell you something. We are the survivors. I've already proven that myself.
All right, Prophet
Brother,
Superstar.
When the 24-inch gun goes up and the shadow falls, they all fall dead. Yeah.
All right, and Captain, what a night you're going to have.
Well, folks, right now we're going to take you to some special footage, the compliments of courtesy of Saturday night's main event, in which the Honky Tonk Man really did a number on the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Look at that, with the help of the hearts. It's unreal. And Elizabeth shoved right down, serious injury done to her. This is such a big breaking event that even the latest edition of the World Wrestling Federation magazine did a big spread on it. We haven't seen the last of this confrontation. The Macho Man is waiting for his opportunity. Let's go up to the ring.
Yeah.
Tama starting off.
Hey, come on.
Here with young Jerry Allen. The youngster goes to the ropes immediately to break the hold. When you come under the tutelage of Bobby the Brain Heenan, if you are good, it makes you great. And makes you extremely dangerous. Well, two other youngsters involved, while referring to the young stallions, they are really looking forward to their part in Survivor Series. They will be in there with the Islanders.
You know, Jim, this is it. We got the Islanders in the ring right now, one of the toughest tag teams. But I tell you what, we're ready for it. We're going to survive.
We're looking forward to that Survivor Series. If we can win this one, this is the one that's going to do it for us.
That's right. It'll take us right to the top.
That's right.
Well, a lot of guys are going to make a reputation for themselves in the Survivor Series. You can go to the bank with that. It's going to be a happening. Don't miss it. Be a part of it. All going down Thanksgiving evening. SD with an Irish whip in. Haku went downstairs, planted one right in the lower abdomen area. Whoa, what a knee drop. Leg drop right across the esophagus, makes the quick tag, and it's Tama. The agility. Double axe handle right between the eyes. Once they start on you, once they get the upper hand, once they get the momentum rolling in their direction, it's tough on anybody. Of course, there's going to be some great teams involved there. Oh, look at that. SD rolled right out, makes the tag to Jerry Allen. Haku was waiting for him, but was a little bit slow. Reversal. Allen on the second turnbuckle, nobody home. Can't make a mistake like that. Those kind cost you the match. Perhaps shoulder breaker, no, tag made. Oh, yes, he did give the shoulder breaker, but the tag was already made. SD runs into the clothesline. Look at Tama. Oh, suspended 12 to 15 feet high. Goodbye, Jerry.
The winners of this bout, the Islanders.
Right now, let's go to a special interview with Craig DeGeorge, live with the Honky Tonk Man and Jimmy Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, in just a few short weeks, the World Wrestling Federation will be presenting one of the most unique and star-studded cards ever. It's the Survivor Series on Thanksgiving evening. And right now, I want to bring on one of the captains of the participating teams, led by his manager in the Mountain of the South, Jimmy Hart, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man. Jimmy Hart, as you know, this is serious business. What are you doing with a bunch of dolphins?
Well, you see, this is the Ricky the Dragon Steamboat stretch now. And here's the Macho Man stretch now. But me and Honky, we'd like to have an Elizabeth stretch now, wouldn't we, Honky?
She's gonna wish she was a doll. Let me say this to you, Macho Man. If you have her there on Thanksgiving night, and she sets foot in the ring again to try to help you, to try to save you, or to try to touch or kiss me, you think she was humiliated, you think she was embarrassed, you think she was hurt on Saturday night's main event. That is nothing to what's going to happen to her on Thanksgiving night, because you're going to have nothing to be thankful for. I want to say this, I'll say it right now. My team, the number one team in Survivor Series, they promised me that they would take care of the opposition. Ricky the Dragon, Steamboat, Jake the Snake, Hacksaw, Jim Duggan, Brutus Beefcake, and they said they would handle them real good. You show them what they're going to do to the opposition, Jimmy.
Look at this, baby. Look at him. Like a pretzel, Honky. Like a pretzel, baby.
And for you, Macho Man, stretch him out, Jimmy. Hold him up there. Listen to him scream. I'm gonna get you, big boy. Now you be there, Macho. It's me and you. And you have Elizabeth there, because she's gonna get more than hurt. She's gonna be drug away from there, because I'm not done with you.
It's going to be one spectacular Survivor Series on Thanksgiving evening.
I got a long set.
Well, folks, the Piledriver album spawned no less than 8 super videos. In fact, Coliseum Video did a tremendous job, and right now we're going to take you to Jive Soul Grove. They really did a job on the Piledriver album, as is evident. Let's go to the ring.
But the Natural's on our team. He's on our team in the Survivor Series.
I understand that.
You know, the new World Wrestling Federation magazine, it's got a story on Rick Rudner, a story on Bam Bam Bigelow, a talk with the Slickster.
Oh, got a lot of
the Islanders assault Tito Santana. But I can't
find Macho Man right on the cover.
Right on the cover. But I want to see this book. I can't find one anyplace.
Well, you have to be a little patient. It doesn't go on sale till this Tuesday.
This Tuesday.
This Tuesday.
This
Tuesday. You'll be able to get all you want, if you're lucky.
Somebody told me it was last, but it's this Tuesday.
It's this Tuesday.
I wish they'd make themselves some sense when they talk to me.
Omar unlashing here on the Natural. Oh, reversal coming up. High hip and knee sent Omar down to the canvas.
This Reed is naturally powerful, isn't he?
He certainly is. He's got that natural strength. You got to give credit where credit is due. Oh, there's a push. Press slam.
The gorilla slam.
Oh.
That's what he calls it.
He
don't give me a dirty one.
He does call it the gorilla slam. I know that. Where's he going? He's up in that high risk area. Look at that. Look at that balance. Oh, what a clothesline. Forget about it, Omar.
Back to the tent.
Well, folks, as we promised you, courtesy of Superstars, here it is, the big title matchup between Strike Force and the Hearts.
We should have had that match.
I know.
At a total combined weight of 515 pounds, here are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Hitman Bret Hart, Anvil Jim Neidhart, the Hart Foundation! And their opponents...
All right!
At a total combined weight of 474 pounds, here are the challengers, Tito Santana and Rick Martel, Strike Force!
What a tag team matchup this is going to be! Martel, Santana, Strike Force!
Against the Hart Foundation, it's pick-up time, Jesse Ventura.
Well, I'll tell you, this is a great matchup. You got the speed of Strike Force going against, shall we say, the deceit and the strength of the Hart Foundation.
Jimmy Hart pulling the titles in his hands. Championship belts, maybe for the last time, who knows? Hart Foundation to meet these two premier athletes, Santana and Martel. Come on, let's get the match underway. Jimmy Hart stalling a bit.
The biggest positive note about this whole match is at least it keeps Chico Santana off the microphone.
Now, wait a minute.
Gives those Spanish people a break.
I don't think he's going to be giving the Hart Foundation a break.
I was going to say, Vince, the question is if the Hart Foundation, even though they defend their title many times successfully, have they met anybody quite with the speed of these two, the Strike Force? I don't know.
Well, the good thing about it is they can keep their eye on Santana. He's not going to come appearing from behind the scenes, you know, jumping into the ring and stuff like that.
Nice maneuver by Martel. Oh, my goodness. Another drop kick. Rick Martel allows you on to a takeout. Based on what we've seen just far, it appears to me that at least the hitman is a little over-anxious.
He might be. He's probably a little tight right now. He made a mistake early, but he's not paying for it yet.
Well, the kind of speed that the Strike Force shows keeps the other two off balance, and that's what they're going to try to do, because if you can keep them off balance, you're going to do a number on them.
Look at this. Double team effort. Santana moments ago. Over to try to get to the anvil.
Now, I think the key to this match is for referee Joey Morella to make sure Strike Force is making legal tags in there.
Oh, brother.
Come on,
they like
Jesse.
Doing that quick tag and two of them in the ring at once.
Hitman tried to scoop him up. Santana rolled. No, nice maneuver by the Hitman, Bret Hart.
You might fool the Hitman once, but you're not going to fool him twice.
The anvil coming out. The anvil finding himself in an arm bar. The anvil with Santana, bringing him back over to the not-so-neutral corner, blocked by Santana. Firing off a series of rights. Look at this.
I really can't believe Santana's going to exchange with Neidhart.
But look at this, Santana hammering away. Santana is tenacious. Whip to the ropes. Back off to the... Oh, no, look at that. You saw that.
Beautiful move. Beautiful move by Bret Hart. Bret Hart sliding down the apron, lifting the knee up, and catching Chico Santana in the small of the back.
With a cheap shot.
The anvil on top of Santana. Come on, referee.
And it's not a cheap shot if they win the match. Then they get a lot of money, and it can hardly be cheap.
Well, right now they got him hurt, and you can bet that the anvil is going to really work on Santana.
Well, you can see Santana's hanging on that rope. He doesn't want to get dragged into the Hart Foundation corner.
Are you looking at the same match I'm looking at?
Definitely. Now look at the anvil's tying the referee up. Brilliant tag team wrestling. And here comes Rick Martel illegally into the ring.
Look at this. Come on, referee. Turn around. It would be a shame if a match of this consequence, of this significance, ended in a controversial decision from a referee. Anvil missing, I think, with the first boot, but he sure connected with the second one.
The Hart Foundation know that their title's in danger because they're meeting the premier team here. Whoa, outside he goes. And they'll
not
pull
the
every cheap stunt.
Yes, indeed, and that's where they can really cut loose down from the apron.
And look how smart. You know, Neidhart's not just brawn. He's a smart wrestler. He tied the referee, Joey Morella, up on that. Got him talking in the ring. Didn't allow him to see Bret Hart do that on outside of the ring.
Tito Santana on the outside. Jimmy Hart a moment ago chased by Martel, but look at this. Still more damage done to Santana, now shoved back into the ring by the Hitman. A cover. No. No.
Oh, look at this. Look at this now. There's Martel, illegal in the ring.
Yep.
What do you mean? Neidhart, Bret Hart's been doing it throughout the match.
And the tag just about ready to be made.
No. Now fair play. Turnabout's fair play right there. It's one apiece.
The Anvil just hammering and mauling Tito Santana.
I bet you Chico wishes he was back on the microphone right now. He pounds his face in the mat one more time. He will never talk on a microphone again.
The Anvil with Tito Santana. And the fans really encouraging Santana and Martel to get it going. But wait a minute, look at this. Oh, no.
Elbow. It could be over.
That could very well do it. Two and yes, go.
Now it looked to me like that referee paused before that third count.
He kicked out before he could come down with the count of three.
The main thing for a referee is to have a consistent count. Each count should be the same, and I feel that that count was not the same.
Santana. Slam to the canvas. Oh, he missed with the elbow. Santana making his way back over the tag. Partner Martel inching over. No. The advance will stop right there.
Well, if Chico Santana doesn't make a tag pretty soon, this match is history. He's been in there a long time. He's been, the hearts have changed in and out on him three or four times. Chico's got to be running down. He don't have much left.
Well, Tito, not Chico.
Chico, that's what I said, Chico.
Oh, no, come on. This is ridiculous. And you can't blame Martel. You just can't idly stand there and watch what's going on.
But you notice he causes more damage when he comes into the ring. If he'd stay on the apron, the referee'd be there to break it up.
Come on, referee. Look what's happening here.
Hey, he's trying in there. You got four men in there vying for the World Tag Team Championship.
Well, there's no question the Hearts will stoop to any depth to retain the title.
Certainly. Wouldn't you?
In the ring now, the Hitman, Bret Hart. I can't believe Santana's on his feet.
The Hearts are doing nothing any different than what Bruno did when he was champion.
Oh, is that
Bruno
right?
Would stoop to any level to keep his title.
Reversal by Santana!
Bret Hart hit that turnbuckle extremely hard.
Now, if only he could tag out. If he can tag Martel right now, they can get Hart right here. Hart is hurt. Look at him.
What a surprise maneuver by Santana with the reversal. Santana making his way over the tag. And unfortunately, yes. Two freshmen in there. Look at him go toe to toe. Brad kept something down. Over. Rick Martel. With Neidhart reversal. Martel to the buckle. Throwing Red Buck out of the corner. Score two. Oh, come on. He could have had it.
Oh.
He could have had the world title right there.
That could have been it. If there would have been no interference, that would have been it. You would have seen new champions.
Meanwhile, Santana. Sent the Hitman reeling. Ooh, down to the midsection.
Look at this double team.
All right.
All right.
That's right.
Slam. Santana gets out of there. Martel trying to get him over.
Boston Crab, submission.
Oh, he gave up.
Submission. The only thing I got to say, it took a double team to do it.
This capacity crowd is electric. Look at this. There is jubilation here. Martel Santana apparently victorious and will be officially called. We hear the decision. Here are your winners and new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Strike Force.
All that, I gotta tell you, there are some shocking things happening in the World Wrestling Federation. All of this leading up to the Survivor Series just outside of Cleveland at the Richfield Coliseum. I suspect 21, 22, 23,000 people are gonna be on hand for that on Thanksgiving night. That's November the 26th, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Fans all over the country, all over the world are gonna have an opportunity to see this one. 4 5-man teams, Mr. Fuji in the Survivor Series, 2 5-member teams in the ladies' elimination. Now, all of a sudden, there are brand new tag team champions. That should be of interest to you.
Oh, yeah.
Strikeforce upending the hearts. And it even, I think, adds fuel to this already raging fire, raging inferno. 10 tag teams in a big tag team elimination.
Let me tell you, the demolition will survive because I got them up 2 o'clock in the morning running around Lake Erie, and they survive. So they can survive anything if they run around Lake Erie.
All right, fans of the metropolitan Cleveland area, right now viewing this with great interest, Axe and Smash, especially in light of the fact that we have new tag team champions.
Well, like Master Fuji says, at 2 o'clock in the morning, he came in and hit me over the head with a cane. Then we went over and woke Axe up. It's not so bad running around Lake Erie, but when you're in waist-deep water with lead boots on, it gets tough to survive. But we did it! We did it!
What about an axe?
You know something, Howard? We asked the master. When is it? Thanksgiving. Where is it? Richfield Coliseum. And who do we gotta beat up? He said, I don't care. Take your pick. But beat somebody up, kick them out of the ring. Yes. Beat somebody else up, kick them out of the ring, and weed them out. We don't have team partners. He's my partner. I'm his partner. He's our master. And we're the survivors.
Well, folks, next week our feature here on Wrestling Challenge will be Nikolai Volkov taking on Jake the Snake Roberts. Right now we're going to get some comments from both of these men. Let's go to Nikolai first.
You, brothers, next week, my man Nikolai Volkov going to get down one-on-one with Jake the Snake Roberts. And you know, brother, if you pull out that slimy snake, then Comrade Zukov gonna take care of the situation, yeah.
I know what you're thinking. 310 pounds of Russian might be a little bit too much for me, but why don't you touch the snake and feel him grow, because he's more than what you want to handle. Now, they say, Zukov, you're gonna be there. And Slick, I know you're sure to be there, but I think you're a little bit superstitious, or you wouldn't be bringing Zukov down to take care of Damien. I just don't think any of you can get the job done.
What a matchup that's going to be. Joining us also next week, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the policeman of the World Wrestling Federation, and also your guy, Brain, Ravishing Rick.
Right. Greatest physique in professional sports.
Former Olympian Ken Patera joining us also here next week on Wrestling Challenge, along with his newfound partner, Billy Jack Hayes.
Yeah, two birds of a feather will lose together.
Well, it's going to be exciting, and don't forget our feature match, Jake the Snake against Nikolai Volkov. See you all next week.
I can say goodnight.
Go ahead.